All right, in this video, we are going to check out the script called Flush Digressions, which is like the most Cronenberg name I can imagine for a StyleGAN script, but it's pretty cool. Besides the name, what it really does is it produces circular loops that are a little bit different than what you would see in a normal StyleGAN loop. It uses both the constant layer, which is like the very, very earliest layer of a StyleGAN model, and then the latent layer, which is like the z-space layer. And it does loops between both those to generate like really interesting images. I can't take any credit for this script. This is all from Adao G-Man. I hope I'm pronouncing his name right. He's a really great person on Twitter. I recommend following him. He does a lot of work in various different StyleGAN models and other machine learning things. So definitely check out his work. And thank you so much for making this script. So I'm just going to quickly walk through maybe some of what the video looks like. So this is actually a really slow example. Let's go one of these. So these are these like videos where if you've seen other StyleGAN models, like you can kind of understand what it's doing, but it's still a little different and it produces like a different sort of feel to me personally. So this is one of the examples. I have a previous one that's probably somewhere on my YouTube page or in other places of, you know, how these feel. And they just do feel, I don't know, they feel a little different. So I like them. So I'm just gonna walk through this script. I quickly threw this into a notebook and I'll talk a little about some of the arguments that you can change and that sort of thing. So let's jump over to the notebook. I'll link to this in the video notes. So first off, run this in CoLab. You gotta use TensorFlow 1, as always, with pretty much all StyleGAN models. Then we're just gonna clone in Adao's StyleGAN2 surgery repo, which I definitely recommend checking out. There's a bunch of other little things in there that are cool. So we're just gonna clone this over to CoLab. And then the next thing you need is you need a pickle file. So obviously if you train your own model or just have other ones you wanna use, go for it. We're just gonna use my little FreeAGAN model here, which you can get from, I don't know, it's in a couple places publicly. Let me know if you want it. Use G down here to pull this down. Now we've got that. The next thing is we're just ready to generate the video. So there's a couple options here. First one, obviously the one that's probably much required is putting out your pickle value, or your pickle model file or whatever. Next is your truncation value. So again, you know, if you don't know what truncation value is, I recommend checking out some of my other videos. The next things are all about this looping side, and it's, I'm still, like, I haven't dug into the code too closely, and I sort of have an intuitive sense of how it works, but recommend like sort of playing with these values. So actually what I recommend doing first is actually just like removing the values entirely and just using what's default and then playing with it from there. So there's a couple, let's talk about each of these. So basically there's a loop size and then there is a loop increment for both layers. So there's the constant layer and there's latent space layer. So I believe the large and step one both are about this constant layer, and then small and step two are about the latent space layer. And these sort of like influence how long the video length is. So the video length isn't like a number of frames or whatever. It's actually just it's basically the circular loop, right? So if it's 1.0, that means a full loop. So I pretty much recommend just leaving it at 1.0, but then how these step increments affect sort of how this works. So if you have a step of two, and let's say your step two is this value, if you divide 1.0 by this value, it'll end up being 400 frames. So if you want a slower video, you make this smaller. If you want a faster video, you make this larger. And that's pretty much how you get video length. And obviously that'll also be like the speed of, you know, how fast the animations happen. So to go back here, this one was, you know, I think probably the default. And then this video was a much smaller value. So therefore it was a much longer video. It was probably like 1,000 frames versus the default, which I think is like 400 frames. So come over here, and then radius, small, and large. This kind of reminds me of like when I do my noise loop interpolations, and like the size is a little, I don't know, there's surely some mathematical value that it's playing into, but I sort of think about them more metaphorically. Like if you make it bigger, it's gonna be a bigger loop. If you make it smaller, it's gonna be a smaller loop, that sort of thing. So let's just go ahead and render one of these. So obviously I'm gonna name my pickle file, make sure it's like referenced here. I like to do this because sometimes these URLs get really, really long, and then it, like, CoLab is not a great place to be cutting and pasting in like long text because it like does some bouncy stuff. Anyway, besides that, let's just run this and see what happens. Okay, I'm clearly not in the right folder, so let's move to the right folder, and let's come back down here. Do this. So you'll notice I set my step higher, like as a higher value, that means this thing is just going to run a little bit faster. That'll make this demo a little bit quicker. So it does, the first time you run this, it'll download FFmpeg, it'll set up your CUDA operations, which always take a little bit of time. So maybe while this runs, we'll just watch one of these videos. How's that sound? Actually, you know what would be really good? Let me see if I can find another one of these. Let's try this one. So this one is using one of my like polarized crystal models. And then I think I have another one here that uses so this one uses my florals. What I like about these is they feel much smoother than some of the other loops that I've done in the past. I think it's because you're manipulating that constant layer, which actually has a big effect on how videos produce. This might be like a StyleGAN1 model that's actually being run through it. I can tell because it's kind of crappy looking. Yeah, and there's that StyleGAN1 blob right there. Let's see how we're doing over here. So see, as it generates, it's generating each step. Interesting. I wonder if it's actually taking in... No, I removed that. Okay, well, whatever. We'll figure it out. what's nice about this script is it does also automatically produce video from it, so you don't need to run your FFmpeg script like I normally do because I'm lazy. And I should know that these start with, I assume, random values, random latent space values. Because these are looping, it's kind of hard to say, like, I want to start with this, this particular latent space, just because of how these are structured. So you can't really control them too much. You can generate a bunch of different examples and different, play with the values a little bit and see what you get. All right, so now we're building our video frames here. So you'll see because I did set this step two value to be higher, we got a much smaller frame right here. There we go, all done. And because I forgot the code to play this directly inline, I'm just gonna download it and watch it. Pretty quick little video anyway. Interesting. Did you see a little eye right there? Hold on, let me see if I can find it. Pause. So this is a pretty early model file. So I think that's an eyeball right there from our latent, our picked up from FFHQ. Anyway, that's pretty much it for this video. I want to thank again 8OutG Man for writing the script. I'm pretty sure he has a Patreon, so if you want to go support him. If I find it, I'll add a link to it in the video notes. So have some fun making some videos. If you do make videos, make sure that you shout out him and me on Twitter or wherever else you're going to share things. That's it for now. Thanks.